This video will cover how to determine the domain limits for a 2D hydraulic model for analysis of a project in a specific location, such as a bridge, culvert, or other feature of interest. Domain limits include the lateral extents, as well as the upstream and downstream limits of the model. This example project location is for a bridge crossing located upstream of the confluence of two rivers. Flow is generally north to south. Lateral domain limits should encompass the inundation area of the largest discharge to be modeled. If the lateral extents are too small, the edge of the model acts as a wall, similar to 1D models. Too large of lateral extents can result in an inefficient model. It is best practice to make the lateral extents slightly larger than the highest inundation limits. If a previous flood study has been conducted for your project area, the floodplain limits can be used to help guide the location of the lateral extents. Also, viewing colored surfaces of the terrain data can be helpful for locating topographical features of floodplains. The lateral extents of the domain do not always need to include tributary areas. If a project site includes several small tributaries and model runs are steady-state discharges, then the small tributary areas can be left out of the model domain since they would not convey water, and therefore not impact the hydraulics of a steady-state analysis. No matter what method is used to select the lateral extents, it is good practice to first create a coarse model that will run quickly to help assess model domain limits. The results from a coarse model provide approximate water surface areas that can be used to adjust the lateral model extents. The upstream model limits should be located far enough upstream to allow for natural distribution of flow before the area of interest. The initial flow distribution into the model is based on a conveyance estimate, which may not reflect the true flow distribution at that location. A general rule of thumb is two floodplain widths upstream from the area of interest. Ideal upstream limits are the most constricted locations of the floodplain with simple hydraulic conditions. Example locations include hydraulic controlling topographic features like roadway crossings or natural constrictions in the channel or floodplain. If significant hydraulic controls exist close to the area of interest, the model can start at that location. If a coarse model is developed, a sensitivity test can be used to determine the impacts of changing the location of the upstream boundary. In this example, the coarse model limit shown for the Western River could be adjusted to reduce the model size. Similar to the upstream limits, the downstream model limits should be located far enough downstream so that assumptions in the water surface boundary do not impact the location of interest. A general rule of thumb is two floodplain widths downstream from the area of interest. Ideal downstream limits are the most constricted location within the reach. A common downstream boundary condition is normal depth, which is most applicable to constricted, uniform flow, not wide floodplains. The downstream limit can also be located at significant hydraulic controls, such as a weir crest. A sensitivity test can be used to assess how variations in the downstream boundary impact the model results at the location of interest, and adjustments can be made to the downstream limit if necessary. In this example, the downstream limit is located downstream of the roadway crossing that acts as a primary hydraulic control. Let's apply this information to a different project area. This project is for a bridge crossing in a wide floodplain valley. There is no floodplain mapping available for this site, so the terrain data will be used to help determine the lateral extents. The primary floodplain is visible in the terrain data between the elevated hills on either side. The tributaries do not need to be included in the domain for this example. Based on this information, the lateral extents could be placed as shown. A coarse model run could confirm if these extents are sufficient. For the upstream extents, two floodplain widths upstream of the bridge area, the floodplain is wide and complex, which is not ideal. A little further upstream, the floodplain narrows and is a more ideal location for the upstream boundary. For the downstream boundary, there is a significant constriction about 1.5 floodplain widths downstream of the bridge. This is an ideal location to place the downstream limit. especially if using a normal depth water surface elevation at the downstream limit. A coarse model run could help confirm that these model domain limits are sufficient. Determining domain limits is an important step in creating a mesh for 2D modeling. There are several resources that modelers can use to determine good locations for model limits. A one-page summary sheet outlining key steps for determining domain limits and additional resources is available at this link.